In this tutorial, you'll learn how to create this powerful shape layer transition using just one effect and four keyframes. I say it's powerful because it can be used in any infographic. You can easily change the angle of the transition procedurally, you can quickly change the colors, and the best part is that you can save it as an animation preset, which allows you to bring it into your project with literally the click of a button. You can use this one preset and get hundreds of different looks and styles. Stick around, you definitely don't want to miss this episode. Hey everybody, and welcome back to another exciting and informative episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. This tutorial will help you develop skills using shape layers, creating custom transitions, and using transition presets in a way that you may not have even known were possible. While creating this transition, you'll learn tips about parenting properties, stacking layers, offsetting animations, adding simple expressions, and saving animation presets. You'll also learn some skills and techniques that you can use every day at your job, for your clients, or in your own personal projects. This episode is sponsored by the good people over at AE Juice. Check out their site by visiting the link in the description below to get amazing savings, as well as AE assets that are 100% free. If you're a serious motion graphic designer, you'll be super happy you discovered AE Juice. I highly recommend their I Want It All bundle, which gives you access to everything that they offer. Check out their promo at the end of this tutorial and make sure to tell them that Jeff Knight from 7-Minute AE Tutorials sent you. Trust me, you won't regret it. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-Minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a shape layer rock star. The link to that course, to our 7-Minute AE store, the amazing deals and free stuff you get from AE Juice, and the project file and preset for this episode are all in the description below. I've also included a table of contents so you can go back and rewatch sections that you found difficult. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is go to our toolbar and find your shape creation tool. And you want to make sure you're adding a rectangle tool. If you click this little arrow that's to the right of the shape, you can see these are all of our shapes we have. We want to make sure we have rectangle tool and just double click that, and that will add in the shape layer that's the same dimensions as our comp. If you hit Command or Control K to bring up our comp settings, we can see that our size is 1920 by 1080. If we open up our rectangle group and then the rectangle path settings, we can see that our size is 1920 by 1080. And something that's very helpful to keep in mind is that your size settings on all of your shape layers are going to be in pixels, not percentages. If we open up our transform properties, we can see that our scale is at 100%, but our size settings for rectangle path is 1920 by 1080. And the size rule applies to all shapes, whether it's a rectangle, an ellipse, or a polystar. And as you can see, by double clicking on the shape creation tool, we have a stroke and a fill for this shape layer. So we don't need the stroke. Let's go ahead and get rid of that. And then I want to change the color of our fill. I'm going to make it a blue. You can choose any color you would like. Right click on this layer and then go down to Effect, Transition, and then let's choose Linear Wipe. Okay, let's go up to our Effects Controls panel and make some changes. So with Linear Wipe selected, just hit Enter, and then let's change the name of this to Animate On. We want to change our transition complete to 100%, and we want to add a keyframe. And now make sure that your playhead is at the beginning of your layer. So if we hit U, our keyframe is at the very beginning of this layer. So let's shift page down twice to go forward 20 frames. And then we want to change this transition complete from 100 down to 0. So select both of these keyframes, right click, keyframe assistant, easy ease. And now let's just select the second keyframe, open up our graph editor, and pull that handle all the way over to the left. So what we have is just a simple animation like this. So now select the Animate On effect and Control or Command D to duplicate it. And we want to change this to Animate Out. Okay, now select our layer, hit U to bring up our keyframes, grab these keyframes for Animate Out, and move it over to where the first keyframe of Animate Out lines up with the last keyframe of Animate On. So we're just going to loop that area right there. So now let's select the keyframes for Animate Out, right click, keyframe assistant, time reverse keyframes. And then watch that play back, and it just kind of comes on and goes back off. So that's not very interesting, but we'll make some changes that will make this transition really cool and something you can use in virtually any project. Okay, so now with Shape Layer 1 selected, go to your Finder toolbar right here and just type in Wipe. And that will reveal our wipe angle on Animate Out and Animate On. Pick whip the wipe angle from Animate Out to the wipe angle of Animate On. Press EE to open up our expression, and we just want to add to the end of this expression negative 180. So now if we watch this playback, we'll see it animates on and then it animates off going in the same direction, which is something that's a little bit more interesting. And this also opens up a lot more possibilities for what we can do with this animation. And I want to enable motion blur just because it has a better look. I highly recommend that you enable motion blur. These kinds of animations just look so much better with motion blur enabled. Okay, and we can see this as an animation preset. So make sure you have your contents and effects selected. Go to Animation, Save Animation Preset. I'm just going to shrink down this window a little bit so that way we can see what we're doing a little bit better. Make sure you're in your Documents, Adobe, the version you're using. I'm in 2020, User Presets, and you can either drop it in here or create a folder. I have a lot of folders. I'm going to put this in our 7-Minute AE folder, and I'm just going to call this Shape Layer Multi Transition. So now let's hit Save. Okay, so now we can get rid of this shape layer here. Go over to our effects and presets. We'll go to animation, user presets, 7-minute AE. With your play it at the beginning of your timeline, all you have to do is double click on this effect. You don't have to even add in a shape layer. It will bring it in for you. So just double click. And if we hit U, we can see that we have our keyframes in here. We can also see that we have our effect up here, the animate on and animate off. Pick whipping the wipe angle of animate out to the wipe angle of animate on, and including the negative 180 expression not only makes the transition work the way we want it to, it also allows us to manipulate how the angle of this transition can animate. Check this out. Right now it's set to 90 degrees. If we play that back, it comes in from the right, goes out to the left. So now if we just change our angle to 0 and watch it play back, it comes in from the top and goes out to the bottom. And we can change this to any degree, say 270 to come in from the left and go off to the right. Or we can make this maybe 180 to come in from the bottom and go off to the top. But you're not just limited to these 90 degree increments. You can change this to anything, say 27 degrees. Now, if we watch this playback, we can see how it comes in at that angle and it animates off. And if we go back to the very beginning, we can see that it actually animates from off screen. So by parenting this wipe angle from the animate out to the animate on and including the negative 180 expression, you can change this angle to anything you want and the animate out angle will follow. So now one of the things that's like really cool about this, I'm going to set this back to 90 degrees, change the name of our layer to transition 1. So now let's duplicate transition 1 and we're going to change the color of transition 2. Just make it something that kind of pops against this blue so that way it kind of stands out. Let's make sure we have motion blur enabled. Go forward 5 frames and just offset transition 2 to transition 1 by hitting the left bracket and it'll bring your layer over to where your playhead is. And now we have a 2-color transition with transition 2 slightly behind transition 1. One of the things to keep in mind though, without doing anything further, if we go back to transition 1 and we change our angle, we can see that transition 2 doesn't follow, but there is a solve for that. So select transition 1 and let's lock down our effects control. Select transition 2, type in wipe in our finder toolbar and just parent our animate on wipe angle, not the animate out, but our animate on up to the animate on of transition 1. So now the animate on of transition 2 will follow the animate on of transition 1. So now let's select transition 1. Make sure you unlock this so that way you can click away and see the effects in other layers. And if we make this angle 0, we can see now that the second transition is going to follow it. And that's going to be the case no matter what we change this to. Say 270, 45, whatever degree we make the animate on for transition 1, the animate on for transition 2 will follow. And you want to do that at this point because now watch, if I want to add in another layer, so Command or Control D, and let's change this color to something that's going to kind of pop against that second color. Put your play at your 10th frame and hit your left bracket with transition 3 selected. We can watch that play back. And now we see we have a 3-color transition here. Since we parented the wipe angle of animate on for transition 2 to the wipe angle of animate on for transition 1, the expression we created for the animate on wipe angle will also be on transition 3 since we duplicated it. We'll hit EE on transition 2 as well. So now if we select transition 1, whatever we change the wipe angle degree to, transition 2 and 3 will follow. And you can make as many copies of these as you want. So Command or Control D, transition 3, go forward to the 15th frame. Hit your left bracket to bring over the layer to your playhead. Let's change this color. We can see that we now have a multicolor transition. And again, I want to select transition 1 and make this angle, we'll say 45. And all of the layers will follow the wipe angle of the animate on for transition 1. I'd like to thank the good folks over at AE Juice for sponsoring this video. If you haven't checked them out at aejuice.com, I highly recommend you do just that right now. Get tons of free plugins from AE Juice that will save time while adding polish and professionalism to your projects. Get the AE Juice Starter Pack, which contains over 100 assets for your projects, including liquid and shape elements, liquid transitions, slides for your slideshows, text presets, flat icons, 2D and 3D assets, and so much more. AE Juice also offers professionally produced sound effects absolutely free. Other free plugins include a HUD package that is super cool. These elements would literally take hours to create, but with AE Juice, you get them absolutely free and they can be dropped into your project with the click of a button. Some of my personal favorite free plugins include Copy Ease, which allows you to copy the speed graph of your keyframes and paste them so you get identical keyframe speeds. I also use Shifter on a regular basis. Instead of going through the multiple steps of offsetting layers, this plugin allows you to do it with the click of a button, which saves a tremendous amount of time. In addition to these impressive free plugins, you can also purchase advanced products at more than reasonable prices. Take advantage of AE Juice's bundles. My personal recommendation is that you get the I Want It All bundle, which includes everything I just showed you. I've been approached by several sponsors and I will not promote their products unless I support them, use them, and highly recommend them. AE Juice is an amazing product and company, and in my opinion, it's a necessity for any serious motion graphic designer. AEjuice.com. I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. I'm all about saving time, increasing efficiency, and learning as much as I can about our field. So make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-Minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers, is guaranteed to make you a shape layer rock star. The link to that course, to our 7-Minute AE store, the amazing deals and discounts you get from AE Juice, and the project file and preset for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.